Hi, this is Manos Brilakis from the Minneapolis Heart Institute, presenting case 14 for the second edition of the manual of CTO interventions. This is a case of a patient with circumflex CTO in a patient who had left main disease in the setting of an acute coronary syndrome. The patient was a 61-year-old man who presented with a non-ST segment elevation myocardial infarction. He was found to have three-vessel disease in the past and he had been turned down for coronary bypass, and he had undergone previous ICD implantation. He was known to have low ejection fraction, the last one being 24%. Diagnostic angiography demonstrated a CTO of the circumflex, as well as a severe lesion in the distal left main and the ostium of the left anterior descending artery. This demonstrates very well the area of the lesion, which is within the previously placed stent. However, the remaining stents in the LAD appear to be good. And there was a non-significant diseased right coronary artery with diffusely diseased small distal vessels. The distal RCA and the right posterolateral were giving epicardial collaterals to the distal circumflex. So in summary, we have a lesion with an ambiguous proximal cap in the circumflex. There is length about 40 millimeters, a bifurcation on the distal cap, and the CTO is within the previously stent. And the collaterals are epicardial. Therefore, the plan was to perform antegrade approach, leaving retrograde on a second stage. And because of the bifurcation of the distal cap, the decision was to avoid ADR if possible, to avoid losing a side branch. As far as the left main LAD bifurcation, the plan was to perform a two-strand strategy if we were able to recanalize the circumflex CTO first. Given the patient's low ejection fraction and presentation with an acute coronary syndrome, as well as the complexity of the disease, since essentially the LAD and left main were supplying most of the myocardium, we elected to implant a prophylactic hemodynamic support device, an Impella. After doing that, we were able to go with antegrade wire escalation. This is a turnpike LP microcatheter over a workhorse guide wire that advanced nicely to the proximal circumflex, close to the distal cap at the bifurcation. And then we tried crossing with the pilot 200. That was unsuccessful, but we were able to cross into the distal true lumen using a Gaia second guide wire. The lesion was predilated with the threaded microcatheter, and then we were able to advance a twin pass. Of note, before doing anything, we did advance a safety wire in the LAD because any disruption of the flow in the LAD could have been a very serious complication, if a fatal. So after we predilated the circumflex, we advanced a dual lumen twin pass microcatheter. And then using a filter FC wire, we were able to advance all the way into the distal circumflex. Both vessels were predilated with a 2.0 millimeter balloon. And after ballooning, there is restoration of antegrade TME2 flow, although there is still some dissection into the proximal circumflex. There is still also flow into the LAD. We place a stent into the distal circumflex and a second stent overlapping proximally, covering the proximal circumflex. Then we predilated the LAD and we predilated the circumflex as well and placed a stent in the proximal circumflex with a balloon in the LAD for doing essentially a mini crush. We deployed the stent into the circumflex. It was a 275 by 20 millimeter stent that was then crushed with the LAD balloon. And then we deployed a 30 by 20 millimeter stent in the LAD with rewiring into the circumflex with a workhorse guide wire and then performing a final kissing balloon inflation. That restored TME3 flow in both the LAD and the circumflex. However, intravascular ultrasound did show severe underexpansion of the stent, both in the proximal LAD as well as the proximal circumflex. We therefore did additional balloon dilations at high pressure that successfully expanded both the circumflex as well as the LAD. It was nearly 2.5 hours procedure time, 32 minutes fluoroscopy time, and 2.4 gray. Several lessons from this case. The first is that in patients who have severe cardiomyopathy with low ejection fraction and have also significant disease, as in this patient in whom both LAD and the circumflex were at stake, having a prophylactic hemodynamic support device implanted can help reduce the risk of the procedure. Second, we did see that when there's a bifurcation of the distal cap, it is best to avoid losing access to the vessel by keeping the wire into the vessel where the wire crosses, and then using a dual lumen microcatheter to advance the wire into the other branch distal to the CTO. And finally, regarding bifurcations, we had a bifurcation of circumflex and obtuse marginal, and then the distal left main. The first one, the bifurcation of the OM distal circumflex, was with smaller vessels and was treated with a provisional technique, whereas the left main bifurcation, given the large vessels and the need to preserve patency of both vessels, was treated with two-stent technique, essentially a mini crush. Importantly, intravascular ultrasound helped us detect under expansion of the stents and treated before finishing the PCI. Thank you.